That's why the perfect guidance, Hidayah Kamila, the perfect guidance is the special one, Hidayah Khassa. And that is that if you are led to the destination and you are unable to achieve the destination, you are unable to arrive at destination safely. This is the guaranteed Hidayah. The guarantee is granted in this Hidayah, a guarantee of safety and security. From whom? From satanic attacks, from Iblis. And this guarantee leads you to the destination. This is Ishar ilal Matlub, that you have arrived the place, the station, which you wanted to. When Shaitan announced this plan in front of Almighty Allah, so he had himself, the Shaitan, himself had to create an exception in his own statement that I will misguide each and every individual. I swear by you, I will misguide each and every individual among your servants who would be going on the right path. Allah siratika al-mustaqim. I will take them to the wrong path. Illa ibadaka minhumul mukhlasin. Then he announced the exemption. Then he was forced to bring an exemption clause in his general statement. He had to make an exemption clause in that statement, and that was illa ibadaka minhumul mukhlasin, except those who are the mukhlas people, except those who are mukhlasin. So plural word has been used. So he had to create an exemption clause that except those who are your mukhlasin people, except those servant of yours who are mukhlasin. Almighty Allah issued another divine statement on his response, on the response of his statement. Although he had already created an exemption clause that I will attempt to, not only attempt, rather he said, I will misguide each and every individual from the right path. Those who are already misguided, now they are not Shaitan's prey. He doesn't bother about them because they are already his friends. They are already members of his party. They are already in his company. They are already his followers. He has to take lot many jobs. He assigns them many jobs and many works. And they have become his assistants. He doesn't bother about those who are the misguided ones. His bothering is just about those who are the guided ones. Already going on the guided path. Right path. As I already explained that he had created an exemption clause that my attack would not be successful on the mukhlas people. So I will not try to attack on them because I know I would not be successful. They would be my failure. Almighty Allah issued his statement in his response and said, Inna ibadi laysa laka alayhim the sultan. O Shaitan, listen to me. Those who are my servants, meaning thereby my mukhlas and perfect servants, truly my perfect servants, you will have no authority and influence on them. You will have no influence on them. You will have no ability to detract them from the right path. Or you have no capability of destroying their desire. They are not under your control. They would never be under your control. You would have no control over them. Now the word mukhlasin. So these were the two statements. One statement on the same subject. One statement, exceptional statement, or exemptional statement issued by Shaitan. And other statement which reinforced this fact. And now comes to the, now we come to the question, what are mukhlasin? If you go to the translations, I think all English translations available, as far as I have seen, every translator translates here mukhlasin, the word sincere. Am I right? Every translator translates, except those who are sincere servants. This is a wrong translation. But inshallah, wait till our translation comes in the market. This is wrong. Sincere, this word is the meaning of mukhlis. Mukhlis. L-I-S. And this is mukhlas. Mukhlis is fa'il. This is maf'ul. Mukhlis means the one who is sincere, meaning thereby the one who is trying to liberate himself from the influence of soul, nafs-e ammara. The one who is trying himself to liberate, who is trying to liberate himself from the control of nafs and shaitan and dunya, the worldly lusts, who is trying sincerely, who is putting all his efforts to free himself, to emancipate himself, to liberate himself, to provide himself the freedom and independence from the control of nafs and control of shaitan and control of dunya. His soul, the shaitan, and lusts. The one who tries sincerely and who is trying to become loyal to Almighty Allah and who is trying to become a true and faithful and loyal servant of Almighty Allah, he is known to be mukhlis, who has already achieved this place and achieved this station and achieved this state. So he has been liberated from all influences of nafs, shaitan and dunya. The one who has already been emancipated from these negative influences, who have been made free from, who have been made safe and secure from influences of shaitan and nafs and dunya, influence of negative mind, influence of worldly or material lusts, and all kinds of lusts, and influences of the satanic influences, those who became free of these influences and got liberation and emancipation. So these are the people who had already attained the liberty and independence from these negativities. They are known as mukhlas.
So mukhlisin are those who are still traveling, and mukhlasin are those who had already arrived the destination. Now why say that accept your mukhlasin people? Because he can't do any harm to the mukhlasin, because mukhlasin are not the travelers. They are not walking on the path. They are not traveling on the path. They are those who had already arrived at the destination. They have safely arrived at the destination. Their travel to the destination of Al-Hidayah is complete. So since they have completed their traveling and their journey, so how can he disturb their Hidayah? That's why he had to create an exemption about those. So mukhlas are those who are standing at the destination and watching the people who are coming behind and guiding the people who are coming on the right path. So the mukhlasin are the guides, and mukhlasin are those who are being guided by the guides, the perfect guides. Here lies the difference between mukhlis and mukhlas. So these are two stages, and I added one more stage, and that is prior to these two stages. That even, you know, Quran, it is hidayah for common man, leads everybody to right path. But leading to right path becomes beneficial and it becomes useful only if somebody has consciousness of the path and destination. Only if somebody is thirsty. If only somebody is thirsty, somebody feels a thirst in him, somebody feels some quest in him, somebody feels himself in search of some destination, in search of the aim of his life, in search of the ultimate destination where he should be. So the awareness of this fact, which disturbs the man and which motivates the man to think, where I have come from, why I have been sent here, is there any authority to send me here, where I have to go after my death, would I be answerable to my acts in this life or not, or this material world is the whole sum of my life. So is there any destination of human life? Are we required and supposed to arrive at their destination? Should we try to travel towards their destination? What would be the benefit of their destination? And what would be the loss if we don't achieve that guidance? So awareness of the destination, awareness of the real aim of the life, awareness of the real objective of life, awareness of the significance of this leading, of this hidayah, consciousness between life